I've already shared a video of how I use Adobe Lightroom Classic CC with Adobe Lightroom CC, but what I want to do in this video is show how I'm using Adobe Lightroom CC, the mobile app on iOS, on iPhone 10, to edit a photo on here. Now, there is something that I think a lot of photographers need to know. If you haven't tried Adobe Lightroom CC on an iOS or Android device, it is ridiculously powerful. In the previous video that I just mentioned too, I show you how I have various collections where I put photos that I want to share as well as photos that I want to edit on the road or on the fly. And so if I go into this Lightroom app, you'll see there's my photos to edit collection. I'm going to go into that. And what I want to do is show you how I edit a photo from scratch just on my phone. So again, this is an iPhone 10, but this will work the same if you're using an Android device or any other iPhone or even an iPad device. So the photo that I want to work on is right here. And if I double tap on the screen, I can toggle between various pieces of information. So right here, I can see that this was taken with a Sony a7R and a Canon 17 millimeter tilt shift lens, one of my favorite lenses. I wish Sony would make tilt shift lenses. And if I tap through, I can get more information here. So, and you can see it was taken in 2004. So this is of Abiqua Falls in Oregon. It's a really fantastic waterfall. It's a bit of a scramble to get down to, but it looks kind of like, I always say that this is kind of like Superman's Fortress of Solitude if it were in Oregon. So what I want to do is I'm going to show you how I edit the photo. And we're just going to, here, I'll turn off all this information. There's the histogram, actually, so you can see what the tonal information is. And we're looking pretty good here. So I typically start from the left and I work my way right on the toolbar. First thing I'm going to do is go to crop, and I'm going to rotate it so that the landscape is a bit more straight. And so we're done here, so I'll hit the check mark. Now we have a nice kind of straight waterfall. Then I'll go to light, and I'm going to start working with curves before I do anything else. So let's go to curves. I'll go to the luminance curve, which affects all of the colors at once. I'm going to increase highlights, get a kind of an S curve. You see how the image now has a lot more contrast. And I'm going to bring up the black point to bring some gray to get that really kind of really popular vintage-y look. I'm a big fan of it. Actually, I've been using it a lot, and I think it has a lot of really cool applications, not just to get the vintage-y look, but to give you a little bit more play in the shadows if you want to add some color or hue to it. So now let's go to the blue channel, and here I'm going to add a little bit of this kind of warm tone to the highlights, and then I'm going to split tone a little bit with the shadows, and then we'll go to the red channel here, and let's go with something like this and there. So I've applied a few different S-curves to the various colors here, and I'll click done. And at any time, if you ever want to see kind of where you started with, just press and hold on the image and you'll see the original and where we've gotten so far. So with that, now what I want to do is I'm going to drop the highlights just a little bit overall, and then I'm going to go to selective. And with selective, I'm going to press plus. I'm going to draw my selection, and I'm going to just draw it right here, kind of on the waterfall. And now I'm going to go to light, because what I want to do is kind of drop the exposure just a little bit there and the highlights just a little bit. And so that's pretty cool that you can selectively edit. You have these really cool, powerful masking tools right on your phone. So I'm going to press the check mark to commit that again, before and after. Now let's move on to color. So here, I'm going to go, and even though I've already added some changes to the color in the tone curve, I'm going to go and select a white balance. I'm going to put it right here on the water and hit check. I actually really like what it does there. With that, what I'm going to do is add some vibrance. And to the temperature, I'm going to cool it off just a little bit. Now I'll go to effects. I'm going to go to the split tone, and I want to introduce a little bit of blue back into the shadow. And you can see how we did a really nice job. Actually, I'm going to bring it a little bit towards the green there, kind of like that kind of aqua color. Hit done there. I'm going to add some global clarity. And I'm also going to dehaze just a little bit. And what that's going to do is kind of counter what I did by bringing the black point up and adding gray into the shadows. That dehaze will actually add a bit more contrast there. So now that I'm done here, let's scroll over to detail. With detail, I'm going to bring the sharpening out, and then I'm going to add some masking to remove it from any of the smooth areas like the water and the sky. And then the last thing I'll do is go back to effects and I'll add a vignette. So let's drag that to the left a little bit and bring the midpoint towards the center and then add a feather to kind of add a nice transition from the dark edges to the brighter center. And so if we swipe down, let's press and hold to see the original. Then the after, I mean, it's a pretty cool photo. Imagine I did all of this just on my phone. And again, that's the power of Lightroom CC using the cloud. When I launch Lightroom CC on my desktop, every change, everything I did here will instantly be over there and I can further refine it and just go back and forth. And to me, that kind of asynchronous editing is what makes this so powerful. So I hope you got something out of this video. If you liked it, please hit the thumbs up button. If you love what you see, please subscribe and leave any questions you've got in the comments below. Thanks a lot, everyone.